Paul's relationship with his family was always strained. While learning to play the game from his father, Paul suffered a lot of verbal and physical abuse from his dad, Sam. His father would not watch Paul play for the national championship against Billy Yambrick. He told those who asked him to attend to support his son and the USHA officials he did not need to be there because he knew Paul was going to win. Sam was a dysfunctional father and burned what little bridge there was with his son. Paul never really had a job, and this led to a number of divorces. His lifestyle resulted in total estrangement from his mother, who lived in San Jose, California. Maybe his children have suffered the most. His son is a painting contractor in California. Another son died of acquired immune deficiency syndrome. Stacy Haber, Paul's only daughter, now in her mid-20s, is learning what a special person he was. She lives in the Midwest. She reaches out to those who knew her pop to hear more about him. Paul Haber boasted and touted himself as the world's greatest Jewish athlete. His athletic accomplishments are strong enough to support this claim. Paul was very similar to another extremely talented and brilliant Jewish maverick, Lenny Bruce. Both men did not conform to society's rules and were rebels. Like Lenny Bruce, Paul Haber died alone. Lenny Bruce said, "I've been accused of bad taste, and I'll go down to my grave accused of it by the same people, the ones who eat in restaurants and reserve the right to refuse service to anyone. I'm sorry if I weren't funny tonight. Sometimes I'm not. I'm not a comedian. I'm Lenny Bruce." Paul Haber and Lenny Bruce were pioneers of free expression and went boldly where no men have gone before or has had to since. They had the all-or-nothing daring of a jazz musician like Charlie Parker, giving the feeling that they do not care for the consequences but are only interested in right now. By going against every taboo that shocked America into looking at ourselves differently, Paul Haber had the perceptions of a great artist, the courage of a martyr. He possessed a fast mind and a great body. Traveling with only a packed handball sports bag and wearing his only set of street clothes to conceal his Popeye forearms, Haber's strong spirit is somewhere on a Greyhound bus traveling to play handball in another town for money or in a close radius to the bus station. His specter is passing through to the next four-wall court.